Action 7 News live at 6. This is a fire alert.
Tonight we're told crews are making progress on a wildfire burning near Ruidoso Downs. It started this afternoon. Now, these are pictures from the Ruidoso News showing the fire burning very close to home.
Now, there has been a lot of conflicting information coming in about this fire, but here's the latest. Estimates are that as many as 7 homes have been destroyed. You can see smoke and flames there behind the houses. There's still a mandatory evacuation for those in the Pine Creek area from Pine Creek to DePaulo Road. And a lot of you are uploading photos of this fire to ULocal on KOAT.com. Here are some of them. The fire was sparked in a wooded residential neighborhood on the southeastern edge of Ruidoso.
High winds are fanning that fire. Crews from Ruidoso, Ruidoso Downs, Lincoln County, and the State Forestry Division are all responding. Air crews immediately dropped fire retardant right into some neighborhoods, and we're told as many as 7 structures have burned.
And we got word from a resident who says a disaster siren like those used for tornadoes went off in the city when it started. The fire is located between Ruidoso and Ruidoso Downs in neighborhoods that are heavily wooded but also have some homes. Now, we just spoke with Todd Fouquet, a reporter with the Ruidoso Free Press, who is in one of those neighborhoods affected by the fire.
I know one of the people who lost their home here. It's pretty devastating. Everything is just gone. I could not put into words how I would feel if it happened to me.
Shelter is set up at Gateway Church on Sutter. Now, we have a crew on the way, and we'll keep you updated during this newscast. But again, late word, crews are making progress and may have the fire under control.
It is a race against time to gain the upper hand on the fire in Raton. Firefighters are facing hot, dry, and windy conditions.
Right now, containment is at 20% with more than 25,000 acres burned. Action 7 reporter Ana Velasquez is live on the fire alert.
Well, Doug and Shelley, despite the wind picking up, we still see the air support attacking the fire from the air. And I see a plume of smoke just on the other side of the ridge. Today, fire officials took me into the Sugar Creek Canyon, and I saw crews surrounded by smoldering ground and also others by fire. Sky 7 found fire still burning up trees in the Sugar Creek Canyon and smoke filling the air north of Raton. Helicopters drop retardant over stubborn hot spots and pick up about 450 gallons of water at a time every 60 seconds. This hand crew from Northern California is among the nearly 700 firefighters battling the track fire right now, working 16 to 18 hours at a time. They know they're up against a red flag day today.
That's a dangerous situation. You ain't got no humidity, and you got a lot of wind, and you got heat. They can run pretty fast.
This is what's so concerning. The winds are starting to pick up right now. It's hot and dry, and that means a lot of flare-ups on the hillside. Another danger, burnt trees still standing. They label them killer trees with bright tape. All it takes is a strong wind to bring them down.
So that's definitely a watch-out situation for our firefighters today on the line.
It gets really windy. Sometimes the only thing you do is stand back and watch and try to get out in front of it and make a line and hope it holds. And we don't want to get nobody killed.
More evacuations have been lifted for the subdivisions on the south side of the fire line, which is right up against that hillside. But fire officials say if activity changes, then just be prepared to leave again. Reporting live from Raton, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
Now, that fire has destroyed 14 buildings, 8 homes, and 6 outbuildings since it started on Sunday.